Hello everyone, and welcome to 30 years of Jurassic Park, a celebration of 30 years of our favourite film and a closer look at the actual paleontology of the dinosaurs present in the film, thanks to information provided by our friends at Everything Dinosaur. In this episode, we'll be taking a closer look at the deadly Dilophosaurus, a terrifying dinosaur which ultimately kills one of the main characters in the 1993 film. Let's dive in. The Dilophosaurus is hinted at very early in the 1993 film, when the characters are embarking on the Jurassic Park tour but are unable to see the Dilophosaurus in its paddock, being left disappointed. Later in the film, the Dilophosaurus finally appears at the film's climax, ultimately putting Dennis Nedry into a difficult position when his Jeep Wrangler gets stuck in the mud. Over the course of a couple of horrifying minutes, we have Jurassic Park's most horror-esque sequence play out, as the Dilophosaurus ultimately attacks Dennis Nedry and leads to him meeting his demise. The Dilophosaurus is a horror-inducing animal on film, but the science around this creature separates itself substantially from what we see on screen. We spoke to Everything Dinosaur to find out more about the real Dilophosaurus. Most dinosaur fans and model collectors are aware that the depiction of Dilophosaurus in Jurassic Park is highly inaccurate. In the movie, Dilophosaurus was a small, venom-spitting predator, complete with a striking neck frill. Ironically, most Dilophosaurus models and replicas are also not accurate. In reality, Dilophosaurus might have been one of the most frightening dinosaurs of the early Jurassic. Thanks to a comprehensive scientific review, published in 2020, alongside some earlier studies, our view of Dilophosaurus has changed radically. Had Dennis Nedry encountered a hungry Dilophosaurus, as represented by the actual fossil record, his demise would probably have been inevitable. No venom causing paralysis for the unfortunate InGen computer programmer, he would have simply been torn to pieces. With an estimated body length of around 6 to 7 meters, Dilophosaurus is the largest known predator from the early Jurassic of North America. Fragmentary fossils of this dinosaur were discovered in 1942 in northern Arizona on Navajo Nation territory by a team of paleontologists from the University of California who were assisted in their excavations by a Navajo Indian guide. The badly eroded fossil bones were carefully studied, and the first scientific description of the delicate and substantially incomplete fossil material was published in 1954. It was erroneously thought that the fossils represented a new type of Megalosaurus. Expedition team members returned to the site in 1964 and uncovered more fossil bones, including a partial skull with unusual bony crests. The dinosaur was subsequently re-described and named Dilophosaurus in 1970. Unfortunately, the fragmentary skull and post-cranial bones were stabilized and prepared for study using the technology of the time, which involved coating the delicate skull in resin, subsequently obscuring anatomical details and stabilizing partial fragmentary bones with plaster. These repairs concealed key characteristics, including the shape of the skull ornamentation, that famous headgear. Two scientists, Adam Marsh and Timothy Rao, conducted a comprehensive review of Dilophosaurus weverilli in 2020. They discovered that Dilophosaurus had a more compact skull, the lower jaw was thicker and more robust than previously thought. That famous kink in the upper jaw was much less pronounced, and the teeth slightly smaller than previously envisaged. The arms were strong and the grasping hands powerful. This was the anatomy of an apex predator, a theropod dinosaur much bigger and more dangerous than most of the theropods known from the late Triassic. It was the expanded nasal and lacrimal bones that formed the crests. These crests were very probably covered in keratin or keratinized skin. Their overall shape remains unknown, but they were probably close together on the skull and may even have fused to form a single structure similar to a casque seen in many living birds such as cassowaries. This skull structure may have played a role in visual display to indicate fitness for breeding or perhaps help to regulate body temperature. There is some evidence to suggest that the casques of living birds play a role in thermoregulation. However, there is no evidence to indicate that Dilophosaurus was venomous. The ability to spit venom was a device employed by author Michael Crichton to help explain their perceived weak lower jaw, which we now know to be incorrect. So it is awesome learning more about the Dilophosaurus, and now we are going to chat a little bit more about some of the classic toys. So the Dilophosaurus appeared in the very first wave of Jurassic Park toys from 1993, with the hatchling version of this animal coming packed in with Dennis Nedry himself, a perfect pairing given how this character meets his demise in the film. The original 1993 Dilophosaurus figure features Dino Strike venom spray and was available alongside the rest of the first wave. The paint does a decent job capturing the appearance of the dinosaur as it is seen on screen, and there were several subsequent repaints in different Jurassic Park toy lines. Flash forward to the modern day line, and we now also have the gorgeous Hammond Collection rendition of the Dilophosaurus, which was recently available on toy shelves as well. Now, Dilophosaurus is an animal which I scarcely think of as separate to the Jurassic Park IP, so I was curious to check in with the Everything Dinosaur team and see what other models of this animal exist on the market. As Dilophosaurus has such a prominent place in popular culture, almost entirely due to it featuring in the original Jurassic Park novel and also its appearance in the movies, numerous Dilophosaurus figures and replicas have been produced. Their figures tend to be split into two main types: those models that represent a long-tailed life predator, and models that reflect how this dinosaur was depicted on the silver screen. Papo, Safari Limited, Rebor, Collector, Bullyland, and Schleich have all produced Dilophosaurus replicas. There are certainly a lot of figures to choose from, and some are better than others. Collector added a Dilophosaurus to their deluxe replica range in late 2021. This model was based on the recent scientific review of D. Weverilli, and the crest shape has been modified. The teeth are not oversized, and the notch in the upper jaw reduced. The Collector Deluxe Dilophosaurus has a declared scale of 140, and at around 18.5cm in length, this would indicate a dinosaur around 7.3m in length. So, at this scale, this figure is somewhat oversized. On the subject of oversized, the feet are too big. A compromise had to be made between the size of the feet on the model and the need to ensure this bipedal figure stayed upright. Overall, at the price point of this model, which is currently for sale on Everything Dinosaur's website for £5.79, including tax but excluding postage, it is a reasonable representation. Safari Limited introduced their latest version of Dilophosaurus in 2020. It was in development prior to the review by Marsh and Rowe, being published in the Journal of Paleontology. This figure has not benefited from the fresh insights provided by the review. The model represents a lithe, gracile animal with a long tail. The tail rests on the ground, helping to support the figure. Safari Limited have a long history of producing Dilophosaurus figures, as their first models, a battling pair of Dilophosaurus dinosaurs, came out in 1995 as a part of the Carnegie Collection series. Colour variants followed, with slightly different paint schemes and finishes. The pair were retired in 2009 and can only be found on auction sites, and because of their rarity, they tend to be quite expensive. Rebor produced a pair of Dilophosaurs too. The Rebel, Green Day and Oasis depicted a male and female. The bases could be placed together so these figures could be displayed as a set. And the Rebel versions depicted a more robust animal with striking coloration. The models also had articulated arms, jaws and poseable tails, and the strong-looking compact skull garnered praise, but the crest shape with its rear spike was purely speculative. Rebel developed a pair of colourful neck frills for the models, and these could be downloaded as a PDF, giving collectors the option to add a Jurassic Park neck frill should they have wished to. For collectors looking for a spitter, iToy Studio introduced a replica in 2021, complete with an extended neck frill incorporated into the model. This stunning model, which included a display base, had no safety test record as far as Everything Dinosaur was aware. In order to import this figure from China, Everything Dinosaur, working in collaboration with iToy Studio, ensured the appropriate product safety tests were conducted in the UK. The additional expense and paperwork were well worth it, as the iToy Studio 2021 figure is a fitting tribute to the cinema depiction, and it pairs well with the earlier iToy Studio Dilophosaurus figure from 2019 that was reflected what was known about this dinosaur from the fossil record. We hope you've enjoyed a closer look at the Dilophosaurus, one of the deadliest animals to appear on screen in the original 1993 blockbuster. Don't forget to like and subscribe if you enjoyed this episode, and come back at the same time next week where we will move on to one of the most intelligent dinosaurs in the film, the Velociraptor. Massive thanks to Everything Dinosaur for supporting this series. Make sure to check out their website at www.everythingdinosaur.com.